I'm Natalie Fenaroli, and this is my Spec Miata. I'm a racer, and I'm here out here this weekend at the 25th anniversary of the Miata event to do the showcase race on Sunday. And I'm going to do a quick walk around of my Spec Miata and tell you a couple little stories about some interesting things that have happened to me since I've been a race car driver. So when I first started driving a Spec Miata, I was campaigning this car for a gentleman named Rick Fisk, who was in Kansas City, and it was his car. And I raced it for him for 2 seasons, and he was so kind as just to let me drive it for him. And 1 year, I came into a breakfast group that we have that he's a part of, and it was right around Christmas time, and he says, "Hey, Natalie, come here." And so I walk over and I'm like, "Hey, Rick, what's up?" And he hands me the pink slip for the car and the trailer, and he gave me my Spec Miata. That was 2 years ago now. And now I own this car, and I race it in NASA Rocky Mountain and Central Series as a Spec Miata driver. And I also do something called Teen Mazda Challenge, which is for ages 15 to 21. And it's like a race within a race, so that's pretty cool. You can look inside the car, which is really dirty because it's a race car. And you can see I have a lot of padding, and that's because I'm pretty small. And as a smaller driver, even with the car, or even with the seat raised up, I still can't reach the pedals without putting quite a bit of padding in that seat. So that's kind of a funny thing. It's a pretty basic setup for a race car. So I've got just basic radio communication. It's a H pattern stock transmission that you'd find in any Miata. Actually, the transmission in this car is out of a junkyard Miata. So that's how you know that it's a great car, because the transmissions are reliable enough that I can use one out of a junkyard Miata and race it. So that's pretty awesome. You can kind of look across the cockpit and see there's a little cooler in there. That's for my cool suit. Basically what that's for is I have a shirt that has a bunch of tubes in it, and I plug into it and it'll pump cold water through the tubes in my shirt. So when I'm racing in some place like Oklahoma where it gets really, really hot, it's 100 degrees outside and it's like 105 on the track, that cool suit is really awesome, and it'll keep my body temperature lower so that I can race longer and be more efficient as a driver. This Miata is a 89, so it's a NA. It's got a 1.6 engine, and it's kind of my baby. And as far as rims go, this is pretty much a stock racing rim. And I have been really fortunate in that I have worked really closely with this auto shop here, and they've helped me a lot because Miatas race in really tight quarters, and they and sometimes you get collected or you end up rubbing with somebody, and they've been really helpful. And you can't even tell, but they just redid this fender for me, so it would look nice and beautiful for this event. And I'm pretty excited to come out here and race in the showcase race on Sunday. I really like the Spec Miata because it is a spec class, and for the most part, the cars are really even. And there's a lot of them out there. Because it's such a large class, it allows for some really, really competitive and close racing. And it's also really good bang for the buck. It's compared to a lot of other types of racing, it's relatively inexpensive to race this kind of car. So as far as getting seat time and being on the track and maintenance, this car is really, really good for that. And so that's why I'm racing Spec Miata right now. As far as getting into racing, if you're much younger, you're still in your early teens or as a little kid, I would definitely recommend coming up through karting. It gives you a lot of the basic foundations that you need to eventually race a car like this. If you're older and you just want to start with a car, the Miata is a perfect place to start. There are a lot of Spec Miatas out there that are already built, so you can buy a race car a lot of times that are already turned into a race car that have the full 5-point roll cage and all the necessities. But also kind of a fun process is building your own. So you can take a stock Miata, whether it's an early Miata, an NA like this, or an NB, and turn it into a race car by putting in a roll cage and updating the suspension and things like that. So as far as getting into it, I would say if you're younger, start with karting. And if you're older, programs like SCCA and NASA have ladders. So you start out with just basic track days, and then you go to a school, and then you start racing, like classes like HPDE and NASA, where you're out there and it's point bypassing, and then eventually they build you up until you're doing the competitive racing, which is what I do. So Teen Mazda Challenge is this really cool series within a series that Mazda Motorsports supports and Mazda as a whole. Basically what it is kids 15 to 21, I guess if they're 21, they're not really kids, but ages 15 to 21, you can race a Spec Miata at a NASA event. And if you are in the competitive racing program, the Spec Miata race, you can do a sort of race within a race. So what you're doing is you're out there on the track racing with all the other Spec Miatas and the normal Spec Miata competitive racing, but you also are scored separately along with the other Teen Mazda Challenge drivers to lead up towards points in a championship. So let's say Teen Mazda kids finish second, third, and fifth. Well, those three drivers, even though they finished second, third, and fifth in the overall, would finish first, second, and third in Teen Mazda Challenge. So all that stuff adds up to a championship, and at the end of the season, if you win the championship for your region, you can apply and send in a business or proposal and go to Mazda's shootout for an MX-5 Cup car the following season. So that's a really cool, unique opportunity that Mazda allows teenagers so that they can work their way up in the racing world and hopefully eventually become professionals. I've had a couple of races that definitely are worth mentioning. I had a race, not this season, but last season in Pueblo, Colorado at Pueblo Motorsports Park that on the Sunday event, I actually won it. And it was one of my first races back in the Miata after going to open wheel cars. And it was really awesome because it turns out, and we found out afterwards, I had been the first female to win a Teen Mazda Challenge race. And at the time, was the top finishing female for any of the Teen Mazda Challenge events in any of the regions before that. So that was kind of a really cool, memorable win because I was able to kind of do some unusual things because of it. As far as some other races goes, there's plenty of those races where just the racing was fantastic, back and forth. I had a race in MAM, which is Mid-America Motorplex, in pretty much, is it in Nebraska? I think it's in Nebraska. Or Kansas, I'm not sure. And it was back and forth the whole race. There were three of us, and we probably changed positions 15 or 20 times in our 30-minute race. So that was a really, really fun one. The competitors that I race with are all, for the most part, really, really clean. And so I've been able to do some really great back and forth racing at some really cool tracks. As far as how Mazda has helped me get to where I am today, they've have this really, really incredible grassroots program, and they have to be one of the largest supporters of grassroots racing in the United States. They've built these ladder series so that kids like me can get and become professional drivers, like Tristan Nunez, for example. They also, I know that, I don't know if they do it anymore, but they used to do workshops on the business side of racing, which is such a big deal because racing can be a very expensive sport, and for the most part you have to figure out how to pay for it, and getting sponsorships is a huge piece of that. So Mazda has put on these workshops about how to write a good business proposal, things like that, that are integral pieces of becoming a race car driver. The talent development beyond being in the car is one of the things that they are really, really good at, and they're also notorious for giving drivers all the help that they need. So whether that may be their parts program, which they give Spec Miata drivers prices on parts that are more like a factory rate, those kinds of things Mazda is so good at doing. For my future plans as a race car driver, I've had a really unique and awesome experience as a Spec Miata driver, but my ultimate goal is to do something like Tudor Cup and IMSA, or IMSA at Tudor Cup, and drive a sports car race, something like the 24 Hours of Daytona. And there's a number of different ways to get there, and I am going to try to work my way up, whether that's through the MX-5 Cup Series or Pirelli World Challenge, or eventually maybe doing the Continental Tire Challenge. Those kinds of racing programs would be my goal to move up the ladder and eventually become a professional race car driver.